Hey everyone, and welcome back to Life of Medical. I'm your host, and tonight, we're shining a light on one of the oldest, yet still one of the most fundamental and widely used pieces of medical imaging technology, the X-ray device. Our journey into this foundational diagnostic tool is titled, Seeing Through You, The Essential Guide to the X-ray Device and How X-rays Work. From broken bones to chest exams, X-rays are often our first look inside the human body. So, let's demystify this incredible invention. What is an X-ray device and what are X-rays? First up, what exactly is an X-ray device and what are these invisible X-rays it produces? An X-ray device is essentially a machine that generates a specific type of electromagnetic radiation called X-rays. These X-rays are a form of light, but with a much shorter wavelength and higher energy than visible light, which allows them to pass through many materials, including the soft tissues of the human body. Discovered by Wilhelm Conrad Roentgen in 1895, quite by accident, X-rays revolutionized medicine almost overnight. The device itself typically consists of an X-ray tube, where these rays are generated, and a detection system, which can be a traditional film or, more commonly nowadays, a digital detector. The images produced, called radiographs, allow doctors to see inside the body non-invasively, making it an invaluable tool for diagnosing a wide range of conditions. It's a cornerstone of medical imaging, providing quick and effective insights. How does an X-ray device work to produce an image? So, how does an X-ray device actually work to create those familiar black and white images? The process begins in the X-ray tube. Inside this vacuum tube, a filament is heated, releasing electrons. A high voltage is then applied, accelerating these electrons at immense speed towards a metal target, typically made of tungsten. When these fast-moving electrons strike the target, their energy is abruptly converted, producing X-rays. These X-rays are then directed as a beam towards the part of the patient's body being examined. As the X-rays pass through the body, different tissues absorb different amounts of radiation. Dense tissues, like bone, absorb a lot of X-rays, so fewer rays pass through to the detector. Softer tissues, like muscle or fat, absorb less, allowing more X-rays to pass through. The detector on the other side captures this pattern of transmitted X-rays, creating an image. Bones appear white because they block most X-rays, while softer tissues appear in shades of gray, and air-filled spaces, like the lungs, appear black because X-rays pass through them easily. Where are X-ray devices commonly found and utilized? Now, let's talk about where these X-ray devices are commonly found and put to use. X-ray machines are arguably the most widely available medical imaging technology globally. You'll find them in almost every hospital's radiology department and emergency room, as they are crucial for quick assessments of injuries and illnesses. They are also standard equipment in many outpatient clinics, orthopedic offices, dental practices, for those essential dental X-rays, and even in some urgent care centers. Portable X-ray machines bring this technology directly to patients' bedsides in hospitals or to operating rooms, which is invaluable for patients who cannot be easily moved or for providing real-time imaging during surgical procedures. Their relatively low cost, ease of use, and versatility mean that X-ray devices are a fundamental diagnostic tool across a vast spectrum of healthcare settings, from large urban hospitals to smaller rural clinics, ensuring broad access to this basic yet vital imaging capability. When is an X-ray typically recommended by doctors? The next logical question is, when is an X-ray typically recommended by doctors? X-rays are often the first-line imaging test for a multitude of conditions due to their speed, availability, and diagnostic utility. They are most famously used to detect bone fractures and dislocations. If you've ever suspected a broken arm or leg, an X-ray was likely your first stop. Doctors also use them to diagnose certain types of infections, like pneumonia, by looking for changes in the lungs on a chest X-ray. They can help identify arthritis in joints, spot dental problems like cavities or impacted teeth, and locate foreign objects that may have been swallowed or embedded in tissue. Mammography, a specialized type of X-ray imaging, is crucial for breast cancer screening. While X-rays may not provide the same level of detail as an MRI or CT scan for soft tissues, they are excellent for many initial assessments and for guiding further diagnostic steps when necessary. Why are X-rays still so widely used despite more advanced imaging technologies? Considering technologies like MRI and CT, you might wonder why X-rays are still so widely used. There are several compelling reasons. Firstly, X-ray procedures are generally very fast, often taking only a few minutes to complete, which is crucial in emergency situations and busy clinics. Secondly, they are significantly less expensive than more advanced imaging modalities like CT scans or MRIs, making them a cost-effective diagnostic tool, especially for initial assessments. Thirdly, X-ray machines are widely available and relatively easy to operate with appropriate training. They also expose patients to a lower dose of radiation compared to CT scans, which is an important safety consideration. For many common medical issues, particularly those involving bones or basic chest evaluations, an X-ray provides sufficient diagnostic information, making it unnecessary to immediately resort to more complex and expensive imaging. Its simplicity, speed, and efficacy for specific applications ensure its enduring place in medicine. Who operates X-ray devices and interprets the images? It's important to understand who is involved in performing an X-ray and analyzing the results. The X-ray machine itself is operated by trained professionals called radiologic technologists, or radiographers. These technologists are skilled in patient positioning, ensuring the correct body part is imaged clearly, operating the X-ray equipment safely to obtain high-quality images, and minimizing radiation exposure to both the patient and themselves. They follow protocols prescribed by radiologists and ensure the patient's comfort and safety during the procedure. Once the X-ray images, radiographs, are produced, they are interpreted by a radiologist. A radiologist is a medical doctor who specializes in diagnosing and treating diseases and injuries using medical imaging techniques. The radiologist examines the X-ray images, identifies any abnormalities or signs of disease, and then prepares a report for the referring physician, who will discuss the findings with the patient. X-ray safety, understanding the risks and precautions. A common concern is X-ray safety, understanding the risks and precautions. X-rays do involve exposure to ionizing radiation, which in very high doses can damage cells and increase the risk of cancer. However, the amount of radiation used in most diagnostic X-rays is very small, and the associated risk is generally considered low when the procedure is medically justified. Medical professionals adhere to the ILARA principle, as low as reasonably achievable, to minimize radiation exposure. This includes using the lowest possible dose, shielding sensitive parts of the body, like the thyroid or reproductive organs, with lead aprons or shields when they are not in the direct beam, and only performing X-rays when necessary. Pregnant women or those who might be pregnant should always inform their doctor and the technologist, as X-rays are typically avoided during pregnancy unless absolutely essential, especially in the first trimester, to protect the developing fetus. The benefit of an accurate diagnosis from a necessary X-ray usually far outweighs the small potential risk. Preparing for your X-ray, is there anything special you need to do? Many people wonder about preparing for your X-ray. Is there anything special you need to do? For most routine X-rays, very little preparation is required. You can usually eat and drink normally beforehand and continue taking your regular medications. The most important thing is to inform the technologist if there's any chance you might be pregnant. You will typically be asked to remove any jewelry, eyeglasses, and any metal objects or clothing with metal fasteners, like zippers or buttons, from the area of your body being imaged, as metal can block X-rays and appear on the image, potentially obscuring important details. Depending on the type of X-ray, you might be asked to change into a hospital gown. For certain specialized X-ray procedures, like those using contrast media, such as a barium swallow, there might be specific dietary instructions, but the medical staff will provide you with all necessary information well in advance. The X-ray experience, quick, painless, and informative. So, what's the X-ray experience? Quick, painless, and informative actually like? Having an X-ray is generally a very straightforward and painless procedure. The radiologic technologist will position the part of your body to be X-rayed between the X-ray machine and the image detector, which could be a film cassette or a digital plate. They may use pillows or sandbags to help you hold the correct position comfortably and still. You'll need to remain very still and may be asked to hold your breath for a few seconds while the X-ray picture is taken to prevent blurring the image. You won't feel anything at all during the exposure itself. The entire process for a single X-ray image often takes just a fraction of a second, though the whole appointment, including changing and positioning, might take a few minutes to perhaps 15 to 20 minutes depending on how many views are needed. It's a remarkably efficient way to get crucial diagnostic information. Different types of X-ray procedures and what they show. Finally, it's good to know that there are different types of X-ray procedures and what they show. Standard X-rays are fantastic for bones, teeth, and chest imaging. A chest X-ray can reveal pneumonia, lung cancer, or an enlarged heart. Bone X-rays are the go-to for fractures, infections, and arthritis. Dental X-rays show cavities and impacted teeth. Then there's mammography, a specialized X-ray of the breast to detect early signs of breast cancer. Fluoroscopy is a type of X-ray that produces real-time moving images, like an X-ray movie, often used to observe the digestive tract with barium contrast, guide injections into joints, or observe blood flow during angiography. Though CT and MRI angiography are also common. Portable X-rays are used for patients who can't easily be moved. Each type is tailored to visualize specific areas or functions within the body, making X-ray technology incredibly versatile. And that concludes our look at the fundamental X-ray device. It's a technology that has been with us for over a century, yet it remains an indispensable tool in daily medical practice. I hope this has given you a clearer picture of how X-rays work and why they are so important. If you found this informative, please hit that like button, subscribe to Life of Medical, and activate the notification bell so you don't miss our next medical exploration. Stay curious, and we'll see you in the next video.